Hi everyone, it's Janet and welcome to my channel. Well, the other day I was watching Jennifer McGuire's channel, like every card maker in the world probably who loves card making, and she had a technique that really caught my attention. She called it the Inside Out Window Surprise Card. Now the card has a shape cut through the front of the card so that it is completely see-through. And this area you fill with either acetate to make a window card, or you can make a shaker card element here. And that's what I chose to do with the two cards I made today. The card allows you to see the inside from the outside, hence its name. Pretty smart, huh? The surprise in the card comes from the sentiment that's located inside but is hidden by either a sentiment or a die cut or both that you've placed on the front of the window. And when you open it, it is a bit of a surprise. Now, I'm completely serious. I think that the brain believes it's seeing everything through that window, and so it gets a little bit of a surprise when it sees there's something it didn't know was there. So as I was putting this together, I did learn a few things, and I'm going to give you some additional tips that she didn't include, and I hope that my video here will be a good supplement to her video. I will definitely have her video link in my video description, so please, please check her out because she deserves all the credit for this particular card that I made in this video. But I hope that I'm bringing a little something extra to the party. And I did make a few mistakes, but I was able to fix it. So again, this might be helpful to you. So let's make this card. But before we do, I just want to invite you to subscribe to my channel. Just hit the red subscribe button. No matter your level, if you want to learn to make fancy fold cards, interactive cards, and the newest card styles, click that bell next to the subscribe button so you will be the first to know that I have a new video for you. All right, let's begin. So I'm going to use Hero Arts Fresh Citrus Bold Prints for my background, and I'm going to also use Zest Wishes and use some of those stamps. I'm going to use the Cottage Cuts Stitched Oval Set for my dies, and here's some leftover plastic packaging that I'm going to use for the windows. I'm going to also use Squeezed Lemonade, Fossilized Amber, Spiced Marmalade, and Cracked Pistachio for my coloring. I'll be using Nina Classic Crest Solar White for my main panel that I'll be coloring on. I'll also be using Nina Classic Natural White, and I'll be using that for the window wells. Both of these are 110 pound weight, and you can see the difference in brightness between the two of them. I'll start my panel by inking up the background stamp with VersaMark Watermark ink, and then I'm going to pour the Ranger Fine Detail embossing powder in white over the top of that, shake off my excess, and then I will heat emboss that. I'm using the Nina Solar White for this panel. This cardstock really works great for inking up like I'm going to use today, but it also works really well with Copics, and I often use it for Copic coloring. It's a nice heavy cardstock, it's nice bright and white, so colors show true through it, and it's really easy to blend on, thanks to its smooth finish. You'll notice I started on one end with the yellows, and now I'm starting on the other end with the green and kind of blending the two together in the middle with orange. When you're done, you'll want to buff it clean so that the white embossing powder will shine through. I'm going to next work on the lemon, the stem, and the leaves. Same kind of process. I'm going to heat emboss that, and then I will begin to color it. So here I go with my yellow. I'm going to use the Squeezed Lemonade and some Fossilized Amber to darken one side of it a little bit and wipe off the excess. Then I'm using the Cracked Pistachio for the leaves and stem. The whole stem is actually embossed white, but I just trimmed around the edges, leaving some of the green around it so that it gives the impression of being green. And then I'm going to put it together, just gluing the leaves and stem to the lemon itself. I'll use it on the top of my window on the card. Now I'm going to use some low tack artist tape from Scotch, and I'm going to use that to secure my window onto the front panel that I did a minute ago. Working in, it's the fourth die in this set. Then I'll repeat the process with the fifth die in on this set to cut it slightly smaller. Once placed in my card, that little bit of area is going to appear as a frame, and it's actually going to be the color of my card base peeking through. To create the space in my shaker card, I'm going to use four panels that I've cut here from one piece of the natural white cardstock. I lined up a piece of the natural white cardstock behind my cut and colored front panel, and then I slipped the die in, and you'll feel it just slip into that hole. You'll know it's in the right place. And then you can run it through your die cutter. And that is how I created four of these window wells, which I'll stack one behind each other. Notice I have some overhanging edges, and I realized it was because there was a slight difference on the right and left side between the window well and the edge of the card panel. So I just needed to figure out where all those card panels went and put them in the right order so that when they were stacked together, they matched up on each side. And then you put your colored panel on the top, and you see I had it wrong because I've got weird overhangs there. So I just turned it around and kept playing with it till I got it right. And then once you have that ready, you can start gluing your panels together to create the window well you need for your shaker card. Now here I just cut a piece of plastic packaging into the shape I needed to cover the window well. Doesn't need to be pretty because it doesn't show. And then on the back side of the colored panel, I'm going to apply the glue and squish it around so that it doesn't seep through when I press down my window or my acetate covering there. And then you can start applying the other layers. So you're gradually building it up so that it becomes thicker and thicker like you see here. Once that's done, you can start filling it with your beads and sequins and whatever else you want to put in there. I made sure to clean the inside of the window quite well to remove any debris before I put in those sequins and then sealed it on the other side with another piece of clear packaging. It was then I realized I'd made a mistake. I should have cut a window in my card base before I started working on the front panel. So I decided to use some removable adhesive, place it behind the window in the place that I thought it would be about centered, and then placed it on my card front. That stuck that piece so that I could then take my larger die again, center it, and secure it, and running it through. I hoped that I would be close enough that I would get by with it, and I'm pleased to say that it did work. But I would recommend in the future, cut that at the same time that you're cutting your other panels so you don't run into this problem. Once that was all done, then I could attach the front panel with the shaker in it on the top of my card base. And you can see how you will be seeing through that. And that's what makes this card kind of cool. Now the inside, I will do a similar thing with the piece that I want to peek through, only this time I'm going to use regular glue. I'm going to position it laying down in the center. I don't need to see the front this time. And I can just push over the back of the card on top of the front one once I feel it's centered. And it's going to stick in place. And now you've got that peek through, and you see the border around it, like I was mentioning earlier, of the orange that comes from cutting that piece just a little bit smaller than your window opening. Now I've just glued the die cut on top of the window, and the last thing to do is to put on the sentiments. Off camera, I made my sentiments. They are heat embossed with white powder again, but this time on black and then cut out with a Stampin' Up! Punch. The front one says, "When life gives you lemons," and then it's going to hide the back one so you don't see it until you open it. It's then going to say, "Make a lemon tart." So this just needs to be secured behind the first sentiment in the window, and it would have been a lot easier to place this the same way that I placed the oval piece, but I didn't think of it for some reason, so I had to keep futzing with it. And because it's, you know, wet glue, I could move it around until it was right. But lesson learned, it'd be a lot easier just to do the same technique. The last thing I had to do was put on some gemstones from Studio Katia, and that finishes this card. I really like how it shows through, and there is that little bit of a surprise sentiment underneath that you don't realize is there until you open it. Well, that was a lot of fun, and I think I'll be using this technique in future cards. I was thinking that on, say, something like a slimline card, you could do multiple windows, and it would be really neat. Well, I do appreciate all the time you spend with me. I'll be back soon with another video.
So if you liked what you saw today, stick around a little longer and watch one of these videos that I think you might like. And if you haven't yet, please hit the subscribe button and the bell so that you'll get notices when I post my next video.